Welcome to 902 Street TV. I'm your host, ZITU.G. Our topic of the day is the art market generally. But before we dive into the topic, ningetaka kujintroduce vizuri. Jina yangu ya kweli is Edwin Kamau, Githinji. I am an art student, an art collector, and also an art advisor. For the last 6 to 7 years, I've been able to interact with various artists, various art collectors, whom have also shared their knowledge with me concerning the art industry. So, doing this special video, I'm trying to share the little knowledge that I have with you, the artist who is at home, or you are an art collector who is based in Kenya. So, let's dive in. I'll start by saying that the art industry is the most secretive industry there is in the world, in that you'd have an interest in buying a particular piece, but the person who possesses that art piece doesn't want to sell it to you for one reason or another. For instance, there are two auction houses based in Europe. One of them is the Christie's Gallery, where such galleries, they try to retain certain pieces because they believe that such a piece may fetch a higher value than the others. But in real sense, no one can actually price one art piece to be of much more value than the other. That is to say, the artist, the work of an artist, it all depends on the elements that have been used in one piece and the time that has been taken to create such a piece. As I was doing my research, I realized that some galleries tend to do a bit of research on the buyers of their pieces. For instance, not anybody can buy an art piece from Christie's. You have to have a good reputation in the art industry. If you are an upcoming artist and you want your piece to be exhibited in Europe, you'll have to have a lot of connections. Leave alone, you won't be told how much your piece shall be sold at. So when we talk about transparency, is that the art gallery needs to inform the public, the artist, or even more the government on how much it's making from that piece. There are some investors that are reluctant to invest in such an industry because there is no criteria that has been set in place to show that this piece can fetch for this much, this other piece can fetch for this much, because it all lies on the discretion of the gallery. So transparency is one of the things that is lacking in the art industry. Secondly, I would like to advise the upcoming artist. You may be established or you want to venture into the art industry as an upcoming artist. You should understand that for your art piece to attract art collectors, there are some elements that we art collectors look for in various art pieces. For one, is your art piece contextualized in the historical background of your time? Or does your art piece communicate emotion? Does it have a soul? Does it communicate with the viewer or the buyer? So such elements you're supposed to incorporate into your art piece, because you can't just make art that looks like art. Even a toddler can make art, but what does your art piece have that the other art pieces don't have? For example, I may decide to draw an art piece that where an old lady is holding a child that is crying. Plus the background may be an African background, maybe it was taken in the Sahara, maybe in the forest, maybe inside the hut. So that art piece collaborates traditional aspects in that it was taken in the past. Such an art piece may attract a lot of collectors. Despite that, there are some art pieces which may lack the face of an individual. Maybe it may be of a scenery, it may be a pot that may have several elements. But if your art doesn't have soul, it doesn't communicate with me as the art collector, I wouldn't bother even coming to visit your art studio. Secondly, as an artist, you need to start your career with a bang. In that you just can't dive into the industry itself. You'll need a mentor to guide you through the hiccups, through the successes of the art industry. Because as an artist, you haven't yet developed your style as yet. Because for the well-established artists, they normally have a unique styles that is clearly portrayed in their pieces. For one, I'd like to give an example of the few artists that I have worked with. There is Sheds Karaoke. He's from Sana City. If you would look at his style of doing his pieces, it's quite unique from any other artist, for example, Kimita. And funny enough, they work from the same studio, but their works are never similar. And what they normally do, what they try to do is, they try to communicate to the viewer or to the audience about a certain feeling, a certain message that they want to send to the whole community. Secondly, or thirdly, I'd like to mention that the artist acts as if he records history. In this current time, we're in the corona pandemic. It would be wise as an artist to do one or two, three pieces that captures these current times. And 10 years down the line, if an art collector comes across your art piece, he will be able to tell that this piece was done in this particular time. It was done prior or after the corona pandemic. So it is quite evident from what I've experienced after interacting with other personnels that an art piece, to be of much value, it has to have emotion. It has to communicate. And the artist, if he'll be able to do that, he'll be able to convert this, a certain principle called the conversion principle, where you convert your viewers to be buyers. Because if you're an artist and you decide to open an art gallery and you open your doors to the public, you'll have hundreds of people coming to visit your gallery. But how many people will buy an art piece? It all depends on the pieces themselves. Do they communicate with the viewer? Once you achieve that, you'll be able to convert them to buyers. And I would like to talk to the buyers or to the viewers. Please support our artists, because if they have taken that journey, you'll need to support them so that they can be able to live off their career or what they normally practice. It's quite a hard industry, for one, because you can have 1,000 pieces and yet it doesn't fetch a high value that you are expecting it to reach. If you'd study the art industry, you tend to find artists that start from the ground and reach up to the highest level in the art industry. It's because of perseverance. The art industry needs perseverance. You cannot enter into the art industry and expect to reap profits in the first 5 to 10 years. There are some art collectors that I am aware of that they started reaping profits after 20 years down the line. This is after building your brand, having immersed knowledge of the art industry, having numerous connections. Plus, you'll be able to achieve your own style in the art industry. There's another artist that I work closely with. His name is Githinji. Most Githinji started. started his career after working under a mentor. The same mentor, he's a well-established artist in the a Kenyan museum. His name, I'll get back to you. So, when we talk about the art style that you are using, it has to be unique. You shouldn't copy or emulate another artist's work because that will be an infringement of their copyrights. And that piece won't fetch as much because if an art collector notices that you have copied another artist's style, mind you, I won't deter from sitakosa kukuchomea picha Kamau art collectors wengine who we hang out with. It's because we like originality. If your style is original, mind you, it will fetch a higher price than what you were expecting. Secondly, I'd like to mention that once an artist has decided to venture into that industry, you'll need to build a foundation. You'll need to have connections so that the people who will visit you or the people who you visit, they will have a statement that favors you, saying that artist so-and-so, he's great in his work, and that's how you build your reputation. If you build your reputation, that's how you build your value. It's not the value of your art, but it's the value of the artists. Because you might find, if I'm a well-renowned artist, I can just draw a banana on a canvas and I price it at 1 million. If my brand is of a high value, or if I have sold a piece close to that value, nobody will question my price. In fact, they'll take it as if I'm a well-renowned artist in Kenya. So it all depends on how you value yourself. There's an artist who came to my office the other day. He was asking me, how does one price their work? And I told him that it all depends on how much time you have used to come up with the art piece, the elements used, how is the finishing, have you framed it, what type of mediums have you used. And if you use high-end materials, then your piece shall fetch a higher value considering the amount of effort that you have put in that piece. And if you're an artist, please don't do it for the money. Do it for the passion and love. Okay, as an artist, you shouldn't create products because of money. Do not be money-oriented because you will lose the purpose of being an artist. An artist is supposed to bring life, to communicate certain messages through art, to record history. But if you're money-oriented, your pieces may lack soul, may lack emotion. But because, for one, art which looks just like art is quite boring. But art made from the soul or from deep within your conviction, it will communicate a much deeper message to the viewer or to the audience that you're targeting. So, be an artist that records history, that communicates. If you do that, then you will have captured your end goal. Secondly, if you want to make it in the art industry, you need to build a connection or a fan base. The only way you can do this is to visit various art galleries around Nairobi or where you come from. For one, in Kikuyu there is 902 Street. It's an art organization. We help artists establish themselves. We organize events where various different people come and interact to share ideas. and many more projects come from such scenarios. So do not be afraid to enter in such galleries and act as if you are the owner of that gallery, regardless of you are a visitor or not. And you need to interact with other artists so that you can study their style also. Not to emulate or to copy, but to study it. After that, you'll be able to understand your own style. Art rhymes with culture. If you understand yourself, you'll be able to understand what your culture is all about. The same with art. If you understand your neighbor's style, you'll be able to understand yourself. Because you can't start studying yourself. You need to study someone else so that you can drive your way towards your end goal. And with that, I'd like to tell my audience, if you see an artist exhibiting on the street or whatever premises that he may use, don't be just a viewer. Please support the artist. Buy one or two paintings and go hang it on your wall. For one, if your friends visit your house, they'll assume that you're of a higher class. Not everyone can afford art, and not everyone appreciates art. But if you have it in your house, you'll feel refreshed because art is a form of therapy. And it increases the value of your estate. Because the art that you have collected, it gains value as time goes. And after 20 years, the art piece that you may have fetched for 300,000 might fetch for 900,000. So that is like an investment. So for such an investment to reach, that art piece must have something that I've pondered since the start of this video. That is emotion. That is, it has to connect with the viewer. And if it lacks all this, it will be an investment gone wrong. That will be like your money going down the drain. So, the artist back at home, please, you need to think about the pieces that you are creating. Are they money oriented, or does it go hand in hand with your passion and interests? So, ponder on that. See you next week. I'm your host, ZITU.G. You'll always find me at 902 Street. If you have any questions, feel free to visit us.